Welcome to the tropical dome,
to the show dome,
to the desert dome.
Come on on.
Oh, this is one of my favorite spots. Just stand here and look up.
As we start the tour of the domes and you park in the parking lots, you see this iconic structure. As you get closer, you start to see how it's deteriorating. Now we're gonna go inside. All of these spots along here are leaks in our roof. And as you'll see when we turn the corner over here, so the leaking that's happening, the deterioration of the metal, and it continues to get worse. The boilers are extremely old. We focus on this part as it's the guts. It's how we keep our plants healthy. So they're monitored 24 hours a day by our staff, because if they go down, it's detrimental to our environments within the domes. They are extremely expensive to fix. Everything costs a lot of money when it comes to the boilers. So here it is in all its glory.
Depending on an outdated system, like boilers that might not be functional, is nerve-wracking every day, because that could hugely impact the desert dome collection. We need to maintain temperatures there. It cannot go any below 55 degrees or those plants will suffer.
Our utility costs can average about $250,000 a year. So the fact that we have multiple boilers in the basement that are creating the heat for these domes, and then it's single pane, very thin glass, and then that's escaping in the atmosphere.
No matter how you measure it, the domes are the least efficient building that Milwaukee County has to operate. When you think about the zoo, the courthouse, the airport, we have a lot of buildings at Milwaukee County, and the domes is at the absolute top of the list in terms of inefficiency.
I don't think that people understand the infrastructure that that it takes to operate it. Those are things you wouldn't necessarily know if you haven't been behind the scenes.
Here, a lot of the work that the horticulturists do with hardscape, with rocks, which looks amazing and very intentional, but at the same time is a protective measure for the plants. They have learned to place and position rocks in specific locations where we have the hardest drips in case of a rain. The constant dripping from the failure of the structure can deteriorate the plants faster than that we can replace them. These are probably all replacements. Right now, the focus of the horticultural team is purely maintaining the collections that we have. So even though we try to incorporate new species, there's very little we can do because they don't have enough time. We try to stay connected to the horticultural conservators in the area, but we are not able to expand at the national level, and that's what we would love to do.
The staff here has learned to work creatively. They've learned to work very much in an environment that's constantly changing or has new issues arise.
The domes require much more funding and support than what we're able to provide. We have 4 carpenters, we have 5 plumbers throughout the entire park system that are responsible for over 450 buildings. Those skilled trades folks spend so much time maintaining the domes and just making sure that we keep the facility safe. We have 14 horticulturalists that work there now. That facility was originally built to have 35 full-time staff that operate the domes.
The county is constantly investing in maintaining the conservatory open, safe, and operational. I know there's a lot of talk and conversation about deferred maintenance and the maintenance that was not done or has not been done, but at the same time, there's just so much that we do every single day to maintain it. A lot goes into opening the doors every single day.
To do nothing, it'll continue to deteriorate, and it's gonna cost us money to try to keep band-aiding and fixing it. I tend to use like bubble gum, duct tape, and string. At a certain point, you just can't do that. So it'd be nice to find a proactive solution.
So whatever the future of the domes looks like, we can't just think about the glass and the way it looks on the skyline. We need to think about how that facility is operating and make the right investments so that we're able to have more sustainable nature in the future.